Have you ever stopped to wonder if, one day, human beings could actually live at the bottom of the sea? And more than that, could entire cities, with buildings, streets, and even schools, exist submerged kilometers deep? This idea sounds like something out of a science fiction movie, but what if I told you that it is already being studied by scientists and engineers around the world? Now, imagine the impact of such news. The first habitable underwater city is announced. What would you feel? Pride in humanity, or fear that something so risky could go wrong? The creation of underwater cities would divide opinions. On one side, people fascinated by the idea of a new frontier for humanity, a new chapter in our history. On the other, those who would see only danger, the absurd pressure of the water, the risk of collapses, the total dependence on technology to survive. Would we be prepared for such a huge change? And there's another question. Who would have the right to live down there? Would it be only the richest, turning underwater cities into exclusive refuges, far from the problems of the surface? Or would it be a real alternative for all humanity, especially on a planet that is increasingly crowded, polluted, and threatened by climate change? Imagine the controversy. While billions of people still struggle for drinking water, food, and basic sanitation, governments and companies could spend trillions to build futuristic domes at the bottom of the ocean. Would this be a revolutionary advance or the ultimate symbol of inequality? And if these cities actually became reality, what would life be like down there? Waking up and looking out the window not to see the blue sky, but a dark ocean lit by artificial lights and sea creatures passing by the buildings. Would it be fascinating or suffocating, liberating or oppressive? These are just some of the questions that the creation of underwater cities would raise. And, believe it or not, they are much closer than you think. But after all, why build cities at the bottom of the sea? What would lead us to take such a radical step? And what would be the first consequences of such a bold decision? If the construction of underwater cities really began, the greatest challenge would be the science and technology behind it. How to create a space where humans could live comfortably hundreds of meters underwater, where the pressure can crush even the strongest metal? That would be the first obstacle, engineering. It would require immense domes, built with special steel alloys, ultra-resistant glass, and maybe even materials that don't yet exist today. After all, how could we guarantee that a building wouldn't be crushed by the colossal force of the ocean? And more, how could we maintain energy, air circulation, and artificial lighting in an entire city without constantly depending on the surface? Some scientists believe it would be possible to use the very power of the sea to our advantage. Imagine turbines capturing energy from ocean currents or power plants harnessing the movement of the tides. Clean, constant, and practically infinite energy. But would that be enough to sustain an entire city? Another critical point would be oxygen. How to keep millions of people breathing underwater? Some ideas involve advanced air recycling systems, similar to those used in submarines and space stations. Others, even bolder, talk about creating large underwater gardens capable of producing oxygen and food at the same time. But would we trust our survival to such risky experiments? And speaking of food, what would agriculture be like at the bottom of the sea? Would we be able to grow plants in huge greenhouses, lit by LEDs, recreating the surface climate? Or would we depend on imported food, making underwater cities vulnerable to any supply interruption? But don't think it would just be about survival. Science could also advance in unimaginable ways. Living under the sea would open the door to discoveries about marine species that we may have never seen before. Perhaps organisms capable of generating new cures for diseases or bioluminescent creatures inspiring new forms of technology. Could the secrets of the ocean offer us solutions to problems we can't even solve on the surface? The big question is, how far could science protect us from the dangers of the sea? And more importantly, could humans really adapt to living in such a hostile and isolated environment? These scientific dilemmas are just the beginning. Because, if we manage to overcome the challenges of technology, another far greater obstacle would remain. How would society react to this new way of life? Now, imagine that the first underwater city is already standing. People are finally living under the ocean. But would everyone have access to this new world? Or would only a small part of the population, made up of the richest and most influential, have the privilege of living in the depths? This is the first controversial point. Who would really live in these cities? Would they be sold as luxurious refuges, far from pollution, wars, and surface chaos? Or would they be presented as a necessary alternative for humanity's survival in the face of population growth and climate crisis? Inequality could become even more evident. While billions would struggle on the surface against floods, storms, lack of resources, and pollution, an elite could be protected in safe domes at the bottom of the sea. Wouldn't this create a new division among humans, the surface dwellers and the deep dwellers? And what would daily life be like in an underwater city? People waking up in apartments with windows facing the dark ocean, lit by artificial lights, and with sea creatures slowly passing by. There would be schools, hospitals, shopping malls, and even parks recreated inside the domes. But could human beings, accustomed to the sun, wind, and open sky, endure living without them for an entire lifetime? Or would new psychological problems arise, such as depression, claustrophobia, and extreme isolation? From an economic point of view, the changes would be enormous. New markets would emerge: deep-sea mining, biotechnology based on marine organisms, underwater tourism for millionaires. But risks would also come: excessive exploitation of the oceans, destruction of fragile ecosystems, and political disputes over the control of submerged resources. Who would own the seabed or countries? Private companies? Or would it be considered the heritage of humanity? And if underwater cities thrived, what about the rest of the planet? Would we invest billions in technologies to live underwater while the surface continued facing hunger, wars, and environmental collapse? Or could these cities generate innovations capable of improving life for everyone, including those who remained above? Now, think about another question. What would social relations be like inside a submerged city? With limited space, it would be necessary to impose strict rules about how many people could enter, how much each one could consume, and even how to behave. Would they be free and democratic cities, or controlled environments, almost like futuristic prisons? These questions show that the impact wouldn't just be technological. Creating underwater cities would mean redefining how we live, how we work, how we relate to each other, and even how we dream about the future. But would this great gamble at the bottom of the sea lead us to a sustainable paradise or to a trap we could never escape from? After imagining the technological advances and social changes, the most important question remains: what would the future of underwater cities really be like? In the most optimistic scenario, they would become true futuristic paradises. Immense domes lit in neon, underwater gardens producing oxygen and food, clean energy generated by ocean currents. An example of sustainability and innovation, where humanity could live in harmony with the ocean. They would be the safest cities on the planet, protected against wars, natural disasters, and even climate change. But would we really achieve this ideal? There is also the scenario of inequality. The submerged cities could turn into luxury refuges for billionaires, while most of the population remained struggling for increasingly scarce surface resources. They wouldn't be cities of the future, but rather exclusive fortresses, further fueling the divide between rich and poor. Would we accept a world divided between those who can live at the bottom of the sea and those condemned to face the problems of the surface? Another possible path is collapse. What if an accident happened? A leak, a structural failure, a submarine earthquake? Just one mistake would be enough to turn an entire city into an unprecedented tragedy. Would you trust your life and your family's life to technology that depends on walls to hold back the crushing pressure of the ocean? And we cannot forget the environmental impact. Building cities under the sea would mean interacting directly with fragile and often unknown ecosystems. Could humanity balance progress with preservation? Or would we end up destroying the ocean in search of a place to survive? There is also a philosophical scenario: the adaptation of humanity itself. If we really spent generations living at the bottom of the sea, how would that change our way of being? Would we become different physically and mentally? And would we, at some point, still consider the surface as our home? In the end, all these scenarios have something in common. Living at the bottom of the sea would forever change the destiny of humanity. Maybe it would be our salvation in the face of future crises. Or maybe it would be an irreversible mistake, taking us even further from balance with the planet. The big question is, are we ready to trade the blue sky and sunlight for an eternal life in the dark depths of the ocean? And you, Would you live in an underwater city?